Hello children, today we are doing the chapter Be Prepared by Ruskin Bond. So before we start the chapter, we should know who is Ruskin Bond. So Ruskin Bond is one of India's best loved storytellers. He has spent most of his life in Dehradun and loves writing about the hills, his childhood and the different animals he has known. Some of his most popular works are The Room on the Roof and Our Trees Still Grow in Dehra. He now lives in Landur, Missouri. Now children, in this chapter, be prepared when I've already told you that in his writings, he has written about the hills, about his childhood and the different animals he has known. So in Be Prepared, he is talking about his childhood and he is telling us about his school days. Okay children, we are doing the chapter Be Prepared by Ruskin Bond. Now, what do you understand by Be Prepared? Why is the title of this chapter Be Prepared? We have to understand what is Be Prepared. So children, Be Prepared. In the Boy Scouts, this motto means you must always be prepared to do your duties. So this is the motto of the Boy Scout. Now children, Ruskin Bond is telling his story as a child when he was in school. The way you children are in the school. So if you are telling your story, how will you begin your story? You will write in first person. First person is I. Like, I am a schoolboy, I study in so and so school, etc. Now here Ruskin Bond is telling his story when he was a student or when he was in school. Now Ruskin Bond, he is thinking about the motto, Be Prepared. Our chapter starts with Be Prepared. So why has this been focused? This has been focused because according to this motto, you should be prepared for everything. If there is any accident or any other requirement, you have to be ready and you should be prepared to do any kind of work which has been assigned to you. Now, Ruskin is thinking about this, but he is telling us in the chapter, I never seem to be well prepared for anything. So, Ruskin, he seems that he is not ready for anything. But there was a rumor in his group that he is a good cook. Why? Because in his school days, he used to suggest the owner of the tuck shop. Tuck shop is, in his school, there was a shop which used to give samosas and pastries, etc. to the students. So he used to give his suggestions to the owner of the tuck shop. So the students and the other teachers thought that he is very much interested in cooking. So children, I'm summarizing the story, Be Prepared by Ruskin Bond. So here Ruskin Bond is telling us that the motto of the Boy Scout is Be Prepared. But he had never been well prepared for anything, whether it was a journey or some other activity, he had never been well prepared. Now there was a rumor in the school that he was a very good cook. Why this rumor was there? Because he used to suggest or he used to give suggestions to the owner of the tuck shop in the school. What is a tuck shop? A tuck shop is a small shop which gives you jalebis, samosas, etc. So he used to give his suggestions to the owner and with this rumor, he won the cookery badge. So, you all know in Scout, various badges are given and he got cookery badge. Now, it was time for the camp. Mr. Oliver, he took them on a camping expedition to a mountain. So, now this was the first night and they were supposed to prepare dinner. Now, who will prepare dinner? Who has got this cookery badge? Ruskin Bond. So, they all of them were helping him, and they peeled the potatoes, they skinned the onions, and they were shelling the peas, and they prepared everything. But now, as Ruskin Bond had to prepare everything, he asked everything to be put into the dekchi. Dekchi is a round pot which is used in cooking. Now, when this dish was prepared, everyone tasted the dish, but something was lacking in this dish. So Ruskin Bond, he asked to add some salt. Still something was lacking, so he asked to add some sauce to it, and this dish turned out to be fabulous. Now everyone enjoyed the dish, and when they served it to Mr. Oliver, he really liked it, and he asked the name of the dish. So one of the boys from the troop, he said, he gave the name, it is Bond Bhujia. Why this Bond is coming here? What do you understand by Bond? Yes, this is Ruskin Bond. So the dish was named Bond Bhujia. Now, next day, Mr. Oliver wanted to teach tracking to these children. So they had to follow the trail. What is trail, children? Trail is something, the marks which are left behind, like the stones or wooden sticks are used so that the followers or the students can follow their teacher or the guide, etc. Now they were about to follow the trail, and Mr. Oliver was teaching them tracking. But in the chapter, Ruskin Bond is telling us that we were not good at tracking at all, and what happened? They were behind Mr. Oliver, but they saw a river, and finally they just went near the river, and the troop was lost. You can say the troop was distracted, not lost, was distracted. Now they were enjoying in this river. Now they are not with Mr. Oliver. They are enjoying themselves, and it was full sunlight, and they were enjoying themselves in the river. Now they were hungry, quite hungry, and so they decided to come back, and they came back towards their camp. So they were in their camp again. We were back to our camps, and now he prepared Bond Bhujia again. So children, now he again made the same dish which he had already prepared the first day. So all the children or all the members of the troop, they enjoyed Bond Bhujia again. Now they were worried about Mr. Oliver, where was he? And now when he was back, he was very annoyed with the boys, and he took back all the badges. So the cookery badge of Ruskin Bond was also taken by Mr. Oliver. And now all the children had their dinner and everything had finished. Now when Mr. Oliver, he asked for dinner, children told him that everything had finished. So he asked why Bond has not made anything for him. So Bond said, "Sir, I don't have the badge, so I cannot cook." So he took the badge again from him, and he prepared omelette for Mr. Oliver. He garnished the omelette with red chili, etc. And Mr. Oliver really liked the omelette. So Ruskin Bond asked him if he would like to have one more. So he said, "No, I would not like to have one more. We will have omelette in the breakfast tomorrow." So finally, Mr. Oliver was so annoyed that they decided to go back to school. But at the same time, there was a bear in the camp, and this bear, he had created havoc in the camp, and he was throwing the dishes, the dekchi and everything, and he entered Mr. Oliver's tent, and he was entangled with Mr. Oliver's gown, and he ran towards the forest. So all the boys, they saw the bear and they enjoyed the sight. But by the grace of God, none of them were injured, and so their camp was an exciting and adventurous one. So children, I hope you like the story. Thank you.